Let us pray. God, our loving Father, we bless and thank you for Jesus, your beloved Son. Father, we thank you for your life that you have given to us in and through Jesus Christ. We thank you for God, the Holy Spirit, who dwells in us, who teaches, who reveals, who blesses, and who every day leads us to know Jesus, to know you, to love you, to worship you, and to adore you, and to obey you above all. Teach us, O Father, teach us every day to know, to grow into the likeness of Jesus, your beloved Son, so that you, at work in us, will receive all glory, honor. For yours is the power and dominion, both now and forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. This morning, let's open our Bibles to 1 Corinthians chapter 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, and we are on verse 24. Do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may obtain it. So there is a race to run, and run in such a way that you obtain the prize. And verse 26 says, Therefore I run thus. How? Because I know I am in a competition. I know that I have to exercise and train myself. I know that the end of it, I'm going to receive a prize. So there are rules, there are regulations, and there is all the things that I need to abide by that God has for my life, because it is God who has called me into this race. It is God. Again, if you see verse 26, therefore I run thus, not with uncertainty. That means I'm very certain of what is expected of me. And then he says, thus I fight, not as one who beats the air. Can you see? So there is a running to be done. There is a fighting to be fought. There is, you know, we need to fight. And what God expects from us, that there is going to be a struggle. There is going to be pain. But what God expects from us is that we are very certain. Certain why? Because he is our teacher. Certain why? Because he is going to strengthen us. Certain why? Because we are looking unto Jesus. Amen? When we run, because the Bible tells us in Hebrews, come with me, if you see, in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. We'll start from verse 1. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Endurance, the act or the quality or power of withstanding. You know what? Of withstanding hardships and stress. Endure hardships, endure stress. And Paul is saying, I'm very certain in 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I'm not uncertain. I'm very certain. And here the author says in Hebrews chapter 12, I look unto Jesus and I run the race. Certainty is because our eyes are fixed on Jesus when we are running and when we are fighting. Amen? Because he is our example. He is our example. We are called to become like Jesus. And that's the reason the Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 7, especially the latter part of the verse, exercise yourself towards godliness. Exercise yourself towards godliness. Because you have to run a race. Because you have to fight a good fight. And for that, you need to exercise yourself. That means you need to train yourself. That means you need to equip yourself. That means you should be ready to suffer pain, you should be ready to resist anything that is ungodly, anything that is not of God, and work towards what God has called to. Perseverance, see? That means I'm going to continue under resistance, no matter what the resistance is, no matter what the adversaries are, but I'm going to continue and carry on in spite of hardship. Why? Because I'm called to this. And I have Jesus as my example. Amen? So I know I need to look to Jesus. You know, in times like this that we live in, it's all the more necessary every day to equip yourself, to exercise yourself, to condition yourself, to train yourself, to be ready and well equipped in Christ Jesus by the power of God the Holy Spirit. Amen? And that's the reason. If you see, what does the Bible say there? Exercise yourself towards godliness. And the previous verse, what did Paul give the young man Timothy advice? Please see chapter 4 verse 6. Come with me. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 6. If you instruct the brethren in these things, you will be a good minister of Jesus Christ. Nourished, please see, nourished in the words of faith and of good doctrine, which you have carefully followed. Amen? Which you have? You're nourishing yourself every day in the faith. How? By the word of God. So you're equipping yourself, you're strengthening yourself, you're building yourself in the word of faith every day. And you're nourishing your spirit, you're nourishing your soul, you're nourishing your mind, you're nourishing your spiritual eyesight and your spiritual ears and sensitivity every day by feeding on God's word and exercising yourself. See, man does not live on bread alone, but every word that comes from the mouth of God. Amen? Satan will come with this temptation, but you are ready to defend. You are ready to resist. Amen? By casting all your burdens on Jesus and by being sober-minded and knowing that He is going to help you in this battle. Knowing that He is going to help you to run this race, and for the joy of being with Him, you are willing to suffer. Amen. For the joy. You know it. See, we are going to have trouble. We are going to have pain. We are going to have sufferings. We are going to have hardships. We are going to have trouble. But am I willing to endure? Am I willing to persist? Am I willing to be perseverant? Am I willing to be patient to what God is wanting in and through my life? Amen? So how do we nourish ourselves? Go to the sixth verse once again. Nourishing in the words of faith and of the good doctrine which you have carefully followed. Amen? Which you have carefully followed. That is why you are certain and not uncertain. Because you have carefully followed the instructions of the Lord. You have carefully looked to Jesus, who is the author and perfecter of your faith. You have carefully heeded to His voice. You have carefully looking unto Him. See, you're looking to the shepherd every day and knowing that He is going to teach, He is going to lead, He is going to bless, and He will equip me and strengthen me in this walk. Hallelujah. Jesus looked unto the Father, see, in all things at all times. You mean to say Jesus did not have hardship? Jesus did not have struggles? Jesus did not have pain? Jesus was not humiliated? Jesus did not have to labor and work? He had to. Imagine the friends that He took. One is saying, I want to sit on the right and left. One is going to betray Him. One is going to, you know, always be jumping before time. And then He has a family who say, you are gone off your head. You are gone mad. They want to bring Him back there. And then you have all the leaders who are against Him and waiting to catch Him to make a mistake so that they can get Him. Can you see? And yet in all these things, he is preaching the good news. Hallelujah. In all these things, he is continuing to do the good work of the Father. In all these things, he is continuing to bless people, do good to people, and to do the will of the Father by the power of God, the Holy Spirit. Amen. That is what you need to understand. Because most of the time, what do we say? Oh, if I had a better family. But Jesus' family came to arrest him and take him back, saying he's gone off his head. See? Later they understood. He had friends, 12 of them. Not one understood him. One is saying, don't go to the cross. The other is bringing the mother, saying, I want to sit right and left. See, one is always robbing money and putting in his pocket. Nice friends to have around you. See, 12 of them whom he has chosen for a task, but none of them really understand. But he is very, very sure of one thing. Father, this is your will. Father, this is your will. Father, this is your will. I'll endure. I will be patient. I will be perseverant. I'm willing to go through any hardship because of the joy. What is the joy? That when I finish this race, I know I've done your will on earth. Amen. And that's why he says, when the Holy Spirit will come on you, amen, you will understand. You will see. You will comprehend. You will know. Imagine Jesus' joy when he saw from heaven when the Holy Spirit was dispersed and came upon the apostles, and then suddenly everything they understood. Amen? We need God's power. We need God's understanding. We need God's revelation. We need God's mind. And that only God the Holy Spirit can give you and me. Amen? In running this race, in enduring, in being patient and perseverant with everything that is happening around us. Amen? With everything that is happening around us, because you have to understand, patience we need with people, endurance and perseverance we need with circumstances and surroundings around us. Amen? Patience we need with people. We become very impatient when people don't turn out to be the way we want them to be. See? But I thought you will become like this. Be patient. Be patient. Be patient. Be patient. See? I thought circumstances will change. Persevere. Persevere. Endure. Endure the hardship. Because God is making you and me into the likeness of Jesus Christ, his Son. Hallelujah. Amen. And that is why every day we have to nourish ourselves and feed ourselves in God's word. Every day we need to look to Jesus. Every day we need to build ourselves to what he wants us to be. Exercise yourself. Amen. Exercise yourself. Fight the good fight. Run the race. Not with uncertainty, but being certain. And the certainty is because of God the Holy Spirit who teaches. The certainty is because you know that you and I have an example, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And we have to run the way he ran. Amen. We have to run the way he ran. The Bible tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 2. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 2. But even after we had suffered before, and was spitefully treated at Philippi. Spitefully treated at Philippi, as you know, we were bold in our God to speak to you the gospel of God in much conflict. Can you see the words there? Spitefully used, spitefully hurt, spitefully treated, but yet we continued to speak the gospel in much conflict. Things aren't easy. But yet we continue to do the good work of God in spite of being spitefully spoken about, spitefully treated, insulted, humiliated, yeah, told as robbers, told as, you know, taking advantage of people, all things. But yet we continue to do the good work of God with endurance, yeah, with perseverance and with patience. Amen. See? And that's what he's telling them. And then he goes on to say, did I take any money from you? Did I covet anything from you? I was like a father to you. I was like a mother to you. I took care of you. See? Think about the pain that Paul would have gone through of being accused, of being humiliated, of being insulted, of being spitefully treated. But yet he continues with perseverance. And then he tells that very church, come with me to chapter 3. See, chapter 3 of 1 Thessalonians, verse 3, that no one should be shaken by these afflictions. Can you see? No one should be shaken by these afflictions. There will be a lot of afflictions. There will be a lot of trouble. But no one should be shaken by these afflictions. Why? For you yourself know that we are appointed to this. How do you like this? You yourself know that we are appointed to affliction. We are appointed to being mistreated. We are appointed to be spitefully treated. We are appointed to be wrongly accused. We are appointed to be insulted. We are appointed to be humiliated because Jesus was. They did that to Jesus. What do you think they'll do to us? Same. Jesus said, don't expect anything else. At the end of it, you continue doing the Father's will. Amen. You continue doing the Father's will. Because when you stand before the Father, there is only one thing that matters. Did you do everything for the glory of the Father and Jesus Christ? Amen. See? And did you run this race with your eyes fixing on Jesus and learning from Him? Every day. That there will be hardships, there will be testing time, there will be laborious toil and works, there will be struggle, but I have to run this race, I have to fight the fight. And I am certain that I will be crowned by my Savior. Hallelujah. I'll be crowned by my Savior. And let Him give me the crown that I deserve. But what I do, I look unto Him and I desire to be more and more like Him every day. Amen? No matter what. Accusation, no matter what the trial, no matter what the resistance that comes against, but yet I will continue to persevere, I will continue to endure, and I will continue to be patient and to do good. Amen. Please see that no one should be shaken by this affliction, for you yourself know that we were appointed for this. Verse 4 of chapter 3, 1 Thessalonians. For in fact, we told you before, when we were with you, that we should suffer tribulation just as it happened, and you know. Can you see the words? Affliction, trouble, suffering, tribulation. For this reason, when I could no longer endure it, I sent to know your faith, lest by some means the tempter has tempted you and our labor might be in vain. See, I sent Timothy to you. Why? To find out that when suffering comes, when trial comes, when difficult time comes, are you still holding on to your faith? Are you still holding on to your faith? So we have to nourish ourselves in the faith every day. Amen? By looking into the Word of God, by feeding on God's faithfulness, by looking to God the Holy Spirit, being strengthened by Him and His power every day, by looking to Jesus and learning from Jesus. And our whole desire is, our whole longing is to become like Jesus. Amen? See, to become like Jesus as we abide in Him, rest in Him, yoke with Him, learn from Him, and obey Jesus every day. Amen? That's the reason the Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 onwards, that God has given us some pastors, apostles, prophets. For what? To equip the whole body of Christ. Come with me, Ephesians chapter 4, verse 12. For the equipping of the saints, for the work of ministry, for the edification of the body of Christ. And what is the edification? Till we all come to unity of the faith and the end of the knowledge of the Son of God. Amen. See, why are we equipped? So that we grow in faith, come in unity, and come to the knowledge of the Son of God. That's why we are certain. Amen. The race that we are running. That's why we know what we are fighting for. That is why we know against whom we are fighting. Amen. Can you see? Because we are being equipped and trained to grow in faith like Jesus and to be united with Him and with all the saints. Amen. And that we know. How? Because we are receiving knowledge as we are equipping ourselves every day. So we are being taught by the apostles, we are being taught by the prophets, we are being taught by teachers, and we are growing in our Bible understanding. For what? To know the person of Jesus Christ and His life. Amen. Otherwise, these are activities. We are growing to know the Son of God. We are growing to the image of the Son of God. We are growing to be transformed and conformed to the likeness of Jesus. Amen. Please see that. Till we all come to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man, to the full measure of the stature of the fullness of Jesus Christ. Amen. Fullness of Jesus Christ in every saint. That's why we are learning. That's why we are growing. That's why we are studying. For what reason? That we should no longer be children. That we should no longer be children. Why? Because we are running a race. We are fighting a good fight. And children won't know that. They are tossed to and fro, carried away with every wind of doctrine by the trickery of men in the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting. But speaking the truth in love, may grow up in all things in Him who is the head, Jesus Christ. Amen. So the whole teaching ministry, the whole preaching ministry, the whole prophetic ministry is to equip a saint to grow up into Jesus Christ. Amen. To grow up into Jesus Christ, to become the man, to become the woman that they are called to be, knowing that we have to run this race, knowing that there are good fight to fight, knowing that there will be hardship, there will be struggle, there will be labor, there will be toil, there will be work, there will be temptation, there will be suffering. But in all these things, we are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. My God will supply all my needs in Christ Jesus. I can do all things through Jesus Christ who strengthens me. I abide in Him. He abides in me. He strengthens me, equips me, and He will never leave me nor forsake me. Amen. And that's the reason. Please come. 2 Timothy, I'll show you. 2 Timothy chapter 4. Please see verse 16. At my first defense, no one stood with me, all forsook me. May it not be charged with them. Can you see? Lonely Paul. No one is there with me, all have gone. Okay, so what is the next thing? I will show all you guys. That's how a normal human being would speak. But see what Paul says. But the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, so that the message might be preached fully through me, and that all the Gentiles might hear also. I was delivered out of the mouth of lion. And why isn't he holding anything against them? Because the Lord stood with him. Amen. Can you see the 16th verse? At my first defense, no one stood with me, but all forsook me. May it not be charged against them. Hallelujah. May it not be charged against them. Why? Because they didn't call me, the Lord called me to ministry. So it's okay. It is the Lord who called me to ministry. It is the Lord who called me to Himself. It is the Lord who saves me. It is the Lord who strengthens me. It is Jesus whom I trust from beginning to end. Amen. so I don't hold anything against people. So I am not worried whether I am spitefully spoken of, spitefully used, insulted, humiliated, rejected, unwanted. I'm never alone. Why? Because Jesus stands with me. Amen. That is your strength. That is your strength, my dear brother and sister. Amen. Because He is your life. And in Christ Jesus, you are complete. In Christ Jesus, you are a new creation. In Christ Jesus, you are secure. In Christ Jesus, you are the man, you are the woman that God wants you to be. Hallelujah. Amen. That is the reason you can endure. That is the reason you can go through any trial. That is the reason you can go through the valley of death. No evil will you fear, because Jesus is with me. His rod and staff comfort me. Hallelujah. Amen. That is the reason you can fight the good fight. Please see. But the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, so that the message might be preached fully through me, and that all the Gentiles might hear. Also I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion, and the Lord will deliver me from every evil work and preserve me for His heavenly kingdom. To Him be glory forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. To Him be glory. Because He is the one who is equipping me. He is the one who is teaching me. He is the one who is leading me. He is the one who is strengthening me. Jesus is the one who is making me more and more like Him. Amen? See? Jesus is the one who is making me more and more like Him. So my eyes are fixed on Him. So I can endure. I can persevere. I can be patient. Amen? Because He is at work in me. So I run the race with perseverance. And I endure. Because I see Him. I hear Him. I touch Him. And I know Him. Amen? I know Him. That is important. Because if you don't know Him, then you will grumble, you will criticize, you will murmur, and you will be upset. That's exactly what happened to the Israelites. They didn't know Him. They only knew His works, His miracles, but they didn't know His ways. But Moses knew His ways. Amen? And He knows, no matter what happens, even when fear comes, even when loneliness comes, even when frustrations come, even when disappointment comes, even when there is lack, there is one place where I will be filled, at the feet of my God. Amen. At the feet of my God. That is where I am satisfied. That is where I rejoice. That is where I abide. That is where I am strengthened. That is where I learn. At the feet of Jesus Christ. Amen? At the feet of Jesus Christ. If you see in Romans chapter 5, verse 5, now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Amen? We are filled with the Holy Spirit of God. We are filled with the wisdom, we are filled with the revelation, we are filled with the presence, we are filled with the mind, we are filled with the understanding of God, the Holy Spirit. Amen? And God, the Holy Spirit, is teaching us that we are justified by faith in Christ Jesus. Amen? And now that we are justified, we have peace with God the Father in Christ Jesus. And when we have peace, you know something? When we have peace, we can go through anything. And when we have love, we can go through anything. God has poured His love in our heart through God the Holy Spirit. So we have hope. God has made peace with us and given us the peace, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So we have the peace of God, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, with us, and we have the hope that he will come back to take us home one day. But God is pouring out his love every time in us through the Holy Spirit. So what happens? Please see from verse 1. Therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And not only that, but we also glory in tribulation. Can you see? We also glory in tribulation, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance. Perseverance produces character. Character. What is God building? Character. What is God building in us? Character. God is making us into the character of Jesus Christ. Amen. God has made peace with us in Christ Jesus. God is pouring out his love in us through God the Holy Spirit. And the peace of God and the love of God and the hope that is rising in us every day is now building our character. God is building our character. Amen. When you run, when you start running and practicing and equipping yourself and training yourself into body, in the body, you're actually building your character. In the same way, God is building your spiritual character. Amen. God is building your spiritual character and likeness by allowing you to go through things and teaching you that tribulations, trials, endurance, perseverance, patience, you're going to look more and more like Jesus. Amen. God is building our character. And hope doesn't disappoint us. This hope doesn't disappoint us because God has poured his love in our hearts. And what is God teaching us? You know, when you were a sinner, when you were an enemy, when you were far away from me, I came to you. Amen. Those are the next few verses. When you didn't deserve, I came to you. And now that you are mine, I want you to be like my son Jesus. Amen. See? So the whole thing about salvation is that God is allowing us to run this race. God is allowing us to fight the good fight, but God is strengthening us, building us, and making us more and more like Jesus. And if you forget this truth, then you'll always be on the periphery and never understanding the core of salvation to bring you and me out of sin and to deliver us out of darkness and to break the strength of sin over our lives and to give us the power of God, the Holy Spirit, to be equipped, to be strengthened, and to become overcomers, victorious, more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. Amen? Can you see? Believers, overcomers, victorious. Nobody can separate me from the love of Jesus Christ. And I am strengthened, equipped by God to become like Jesus. Amen. Come with me. Romans chapter 8. Please see. Verse 28. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God. Because God has poured his love in our hearts. And we love him because of what he has done in us. To those who are called according to his purpose. And this is his purpose. 29th verse. For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son. Amen. So what is God's purpose? That you and I get into the image of his son. That he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Hallelujah. Moreover, whom he predestined, these he also called, whom he called, these he also justified, and whom he justified, these he also glorified. Amen. See, one day we'll be glorified into the likeness of Jesus Christ. And God has started the work already in you and in me. Amen. So, no matter what the struggles are, no matter what the fight is, no matter how the running of the race is, we are very certain. We are very certain. Why? Because we have Jesus as our role model. We are very certain. I will fight the good fight, I will run the race. And the end of the race is that I want to be like Jesus. Amen? I want to be like Jesus. I want to be like Jesus. I want to be like Jesus. I desire to be like Jesus. And I have a longing in my heart. When will I be like you, Jesus? That's the hope. That's the hope that God puts into a believer's heart. And that is why the Bible says, no, children, you don't even know what you're going to be. But when you see him face to face, you will be like him. Amen. Amen. And that is why God is saying, that is the certainty that we have. That's why we are willing to run the race and fight the good fight, fixing our eyes on Jesus. Because at the end of the race, that is what I want to look like. Amen. And God is building me from now only, brick by brick, brick by brick, by the teaching, by the preaching, by the prophecy, by the word of grace that comes from every side, is building the man and the woman to be more and more like Jesus, and to hope for this, and to wait for this with longing. That's what a believer is. Living a blameless life, living a holy life, living a godly life by the power given to him and the grace given to him, and is waiting, when will you come to take me home, and when will I become like you? Amen? That is the predestination of God, the design of God. Jesus is the first fruit, and we are the next into his likeness. So run the race in such a way. Fight the good fight in such a way that we look to him, be transformed into his image, be conformed into his likeness. And that should be our heart's desire every day as believers, to walk as he walked. Amen? That's the reason the Bible says in James chapter 5, if you see James chapter 5, verse 7, therefore, be patient, brethren, until the coming of the Lord. Amen? Be patient until the coming of the Lord. Endure, persevere, be patient until the coming of the Lord. Why? Because you are expecting the Lord to come and take you with him. You are expecting the Lord Jesus to make you like him. You are expecting to rejoice in him, be glad in him, enjoy him fully forever. Amen? So you're willing to suffer anything now. Because this is God's will. You're willing to become more and more like him here. Amen? Because after going there, you will be fully like him. Glory to glory. Now you're just seeing in parts. There you will see fully. Amen? But the question is, if you're not seeing in parts now, you'll get frustrated. You'll get disappointed. You will lose hope if you're not seeing in part. See? But if you're seeing in part, you're understanding, you're being touched and taught by the Holy Spirit of God, then it becomes better. Amen? It becomes better. What becomes better? You now become understanding, you become patient, you become loving, because you know God is at work in you. Amen? And you're waiting with longing. When will I become fully like you, Jesus? Amen? Because your eyes are fixed on him and you want to be like him. Therefore, be patient, brethren, until the coming of the Lord. See how the farmer waits for the precious fruits of the earth, waiting patiently for it until it receives the early and the latter rain. You also be patient. Please see, establish your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is at hand. And if you do that, the next verse, do not grumble against each other. Grumbling goes away when you are waiting for Him, when you are established in Him, when you are looking towards Him, when you are doing His will. Grumbling automatically goes away, complaining goes away. See? Because you know who is with you. Amen? Please see, do not grumble against one another, brethren, lest you be condemned. Behold, the judge is standing at the door. My brethren, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord as an example of suffering and patience. Can you see? Be willing to suffer. Be willing to be patient. Be willing to endure. Be willing to be perseverant. Why? Because your heart is established in the Lord Jesus. Amen? And God the Holy Spirit is teaching you every day. Please see. Indeed, we count them blessed who endured. You have heard of the perseverance of Job and seen the end intent by the Lord, that the Lord is very compassionate and merciful. Amen? The Lord is very compassionate and? He is a very just judge. He will reward you. He will bless you for your endurance. He will bless you for your hard work. He will bless you for your toil. He will bless you for the work that you have done when nobody has seen. He will bless you for the times that you have patiently withheld your anger, and when people have spitefully said things and done things, but you have drank the cup and you have said, "Thy will be done." Blessed are you. Blessed are you. Blessed are you. Blessed are you. Amen. Endure. 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 Endure the hardship, the toil, the abuse, the insult, the humiliation, the spitefully being used, wrongly accused. Just endure. Great is your reward. Great is your reward. Amen? Because you're being built into His character, and that's your reward. Amen? You're being built into His character. You're being built into His likeness. You're being built into Christ Jesus. Take heart as an elect of God. Come with me. Come with me. I'll show you. Colossians. See with me. Colossians chapter 3, verse 12. Therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another, forgiving one another, if anyone has a complaint against another, even as Jesus Christ forgave you, you also must forgive them. But above all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection, and let the peace of God rule in your heart, to which also you were called in one body, and be thankful. Amen? See, let God's word build you. Let God's word enrich you. Feed on God's faithfulness every day. Amen? And endure hardship. Persevere. And be patient. Amen? For this is the will of God. That God is building our character and making us tender, merciful, kind, meek, gentle, humble, and loving, just as our Savior Jesus is. Amen. Come to me, learn from me, for I am meek, gentle, and humble of heart. Take my yoke on you and learn from me, and you will find rest for your soul. Amen. You want rest? Then learn from Jesus every day. Amen. And learn that He is building us. He is building us brick by brick to become more like Him. Amen. He is building us so that we start looking like Him, thinking like Him, and believing like Him, and becoming like Him. Amen. By the power and work of God, the Holy Spirit, and by the Word of God, may you and I be enriched in faith. nourished in faith, grow in faith every day to endure, persevere, and be patient like Jesus. Amen. Let's pray. God, our loving Father, we bless and thank you for Jesus, your beloved Son. We just submit and surrender ourselves to you this morning. We thank you for Jesus, our Savior. Teach us, Father, to endure. Teach us, Father, to persevere. Teach us, Father, to look to Jesus in all things at all times. Father, into your hands we commit our spirit. Give us the grace to endure. Give us the perseverance. Give us that strength and the ability of God the Holy Spirit as we look into your word every day, as we eat and drink of Jesus every day, and as we grow in the anointing of God the Holy Spirit. May we learn, may we be equipped, may we be strengthened to become overcomers, conquerors, and victorious in Christ Jesus, to endure, to persevere, to be patient, and above all to love as Jesus loved, and to become more and more like him. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Stay blessed in Jesus. Amen.